And the fans are ready for this one. It's time for the Sooners versus the Huskers in this classic rivalry game. And now the coin toss, and it's presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Guillory has the ball teed up, and we're just about ready to get this one started. He'll return it from the 4-yard line. Across the 30. And the kicker comes in to make the tackle.
You know, Herbie, for an offensive coordinator, he's got to love this kid. Jefferson's decision-making abilities make him very effective against any defense he's ever played with.
Well, defenses have to put pressure on him and not let him get comfortable. If you allow him to scan the field, he'll simply pick you apart. If you can disrupt his rhythm, it'll give you a chance of at least shutting him down.
And he's taken down
right around the 42-yard line.
From their own 42-yard line, second down. They'll line up with five wide receivers. He gets out to about the 42-yard line. Yardage on that run, and he carried that one for a few yards.
You know, when you have a guy that can grab 5 yards or so consistently, it sure takes some of the pressure off the passing game.
Up the middle for a nice game. They're about 4 yards away here on second down. Throws a laser across the middle, and they make the stop at the 35.
When you can move the ball downfield in big chunks like that, you've got the defense right where you want them.
And down he goes at the 19.
This is the kind of steady, strong drive that coaches love to see. Right now, they're firing on all cylinders.
It's first and 10, ball on the 19-yard line. He's got an opening. Touchdown, Cornhuskers. He makes the PAT, a 7-play, 65-yard drive, and they put up 7 points.
Brad, that's one of those drives that can just tear you apart. That can really demoralize a defense when they drive the ball down the field, and a lot of the yards came on the ground.
Cooper gets set to kick this one away. Clayton fields it at the 1. And he's taken down at the 25-yard line. Now the offense gets ready to take their first crack at it. Laterals back, and he's got space. He's at the 40. He's at the 30. To the 20. Tackle at the 1-yard line. That was a huge lift.
Brad, you're right. A run like that can really get the momentum rolling.
Watch the team. Watch the team. Watch the team.
Red, kill, two. Kill.
Green, red, 9.
36. 36.
Oklahoma!
kid is a really reliable weapon. You definitely want the football in his hands near the end zone, and he showed you why right there.
We'll be tied with the extra point. He splits the uprights with the extra point. It was a quick three-play, 74-yard drive, and that's good for a touchdown.
You know, you always prepare your offense to think that we're going to have some success. These guys got to be coming over the sidelines after touchdown, saying, man, I didn't expect it to be this easy.
Brought down at the 31-yard line. Every drive's important in a tie game. I look for both sides to come out with some urgency.
He's on the run.
He's at midfield. Brought down at about the 41. First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 41-yard line. Fires to the wideout, first down. They'll bring him down right around the 26-yard line. Got a first and 10. Ball on the 26-yard line. And he's got it. Out of bounds at the 8.
Good job by the offensive line to pick up the linebacker on the blitz. That gave the quarterback enough time to find his man for a nice game.
First down, and they've got their eyes on that goal line.
Has some daylight. Touchdown, Nebraska.
That gives him another touchdown to go along with the one he scored earlier.
Yeah, he has a lot of freedom to make plays like that, and he can do it because of his athletic ability. The coaches recognize that, and it's proven to be successful.
And he adds the extra point. Nebraska kicked this one off. From the 7. He's tackled at the 30-yard line.
Boy, the two offensive coordinators have to be loving this. In fact, you can look over at our booth next to us and see how much they're enjoying it with the big smile on their face. The defensive coordinators, on the other hand, might be looking for a pink slip on Monday.
It's early in this game, so the defense can still have an opportunity to make some adjustments. But if things don't turn around in a hurry, it's really going to start to affect the psyche of that defensive line.
Pushed out of bounds.
Mike, the team. Let's go one more.
Go. Nice run up the middle. And he's tackled around the 36-yard line. They go with the option and pick up the first down.
Yeah, and that was a situation where the quarterback knew he could pick up the first down if he kept it himself. That's a good decision.
Tackle made at about the 21.
Kill.
36. And he's tackled.
tackled after positive yardage. They need about 3 yards to get the first here on second down.
15's the mic. 15's the mic. I got 15.
Here we go.
Huge play, and it's going to be first and goal. At the 3 yard line, he's going to pick up less than a yard on the quarterback scramble. So at the end of one, the Cornhuskers lead 14-7. Welcome back here. We resume action now here in the second quarter. He is drilled at the 11-yard line. Well, it's third and goal, and they're 10 yards out. Quickly into the end zone, caught for the touchdown. That was a well-drawn-up play for the wideout.
Yeah, they saw something upstairs. It led to a touchdown. You can thank the play calling there. Very impressive.
They call it a catch, but the booth signaled down to the referee that they'd like to take another peek at this.
Man, as I see this play again, it really looks like he made the correct call on the field.
The ruling on the field will stand. He caught it.
The only thing left to say about this play is that was an excellent catch.
They'll line up for the extra point in an attempt to tie the game. And he tacks on the extra point. Oklahoma is ready to kick it away. He's to the 20. He makes it out maybe to the 26-yard line. Both these defensive coordinators have got to be going crazy right now. We've had four straight possessions in which these offenses have put points on the board. You always want to go in the locker room with momentum, so as we get closer to halftime, I think we'll see more and more attempts to create big plays. He's taken down at about the 45. Their own 45-yard line. First down.
Hey, Mike 20, Mike 20. 20.
Makes it to the 47. It and he's looking for more. Zips it to the back, and he's tackled in the open field. From the 40-yard line, first down. He gets out to about the 38-yard line. Gets out to about the 35-yard line. Third and five situation. Ball on the 35-yard line.
he tries to buy some time.
Quarterback's going to run it, and he's got room to work. And he's taken down at the 23-yard line. Tack on any yardage.
And this is the eighth play of the drive. The 10.
What a play to set him up with a first and goal. First and goal from the 5, and looking to cap this off with a touchdown.
Scrambling around. And he's going to run this one in. Touchdown. And he hits the PAT. So a 9-play, 74-yard drive. And it's good for 7 points. Cooper has the ball set, and he looks ready to kick this one deep. He's out to the 30. Tackle made at the 33-yard line.
Well, somewhere Andre Ware's doing a game today, and he'd be smiling if he was doing this one. We've got nothing but offense going on in this football game. There hasn't been too much daylight between these two teams. In games like this, some players try to press too much, and that can cause mistakes.
Scrambling. And he hits him hard at the 40-yard line. Roach picks up about 7 yards there, scrambling away from the pressure. 2 minutes to go in the half. Takes it up the middle for a nice run. He's in trouble. And a nice catch there before he stepped out of bounds. First and 10. Ball on the 38-yard line. Quick throw out to the receiver. And he's immediately tackled. They just took what the defense gave them on that play.
Yeah, you're right. That was a good job of getting that pass completed for positive yardage.
Stays in bounds to make a nice catch. Nice pickup as they connect on the pass play.
Well, they look to be in sync right now. They're both reading the defense properly, and the result is a nice game.
First down, 10 to go.
Ball on the 21. Pulls it in, and he's in the open field. And they make the stop at the 14.
Oklahoma is going to have to use their second time out of the half.
Don't get nervous. 15's the mark. 15's the mark. I got 19.
Throws it out there. And this play is number 8 on the drive. Quickly to the tailback. And down he goes at the 14-yard line.
Excellent job here by the defense to sniff that one out before it turned into a first down.
So the kicking team is on the field. They'll try for 3. It's up, and it is good. Looks like they're ready for the kick. He'll return it from the six. He's out to the 30. He's knocked out of bounds.
At about the 35, the Cornhuskers right now are getting the play out of their quarterback that they expected, maybe even better than they expected. And now, as we get near halftime, there's going to have to be some adjustments made on the other side of the ball.
Well, the defense has got to be happy we're getting close to halftime so they can go back to the drawing board and try to figure out a way to slow down this quarterback. I think that more often than not, you look back at the first half and you think about, okay, let's eliminate this, this, and this, and let's maybe try a completely different way of trying to attack him. In my opinion, they've got to take some chances and be more aggressive in trying to put pressure on him.
What they've done so far hasn't worked.
He's at midfield. That's a great tackle at the 45. Nebraska will take a timeout. That's their second of the half. First and 10. Ball on the 45-yard line. Nebraska is up four. He's scrambling. Tackle around the 41-yard line. He's on the run. Decides to slide. Jefferson gains about 2 yards on the scramble.
The sophomore just stuck it to the ball carrier right there. That's a very good tackle.
One more play now before we hit halftime, so they'll most likely throw one towards the end zone here.
He goes downtown, and he's hit immediately.
Well, if you like offense, you loved our first half. Nebraska leads it 21-17.
We've played 30 minutes. Glad to have you with us on the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. David Pollack and I here in the studio to break down everything that just happened in your game.
What a terrific first half. This is everything we anticipated this game being, and we're going to be riveted to this game, I feel like, David, in the second half, anticipating a terrific finish.
It's fun. It's living up to the hype every single time. We can't even turn the channel here. We got it on the big screen, on the big 60-inch. Yes, it's quite nice, by the way, too. The weather's nice and warm. It's beautiful. Got some chips. We're opening them up a little bit. But great game, living up to the hype. It definitely feels like both teams are evenly matched. It feels like it can go either way. It feels like it's going to come down to the wire. And the only thing I hope it doesn't come down to is a kicker. Please don't come down to a kick in the end. Both these teams playing great D, playing great O, you know, physical, you know, pounding on each other, making big plays. Don't come down to a finesse kick by, like, a soccer player, please.
David's ready to get back on that couch, get the remote, get all the games dialed up to watch what's going on around the country. Time to get you back for your second half. Brad and Kirk, ready to roll.
Welcome back to the action. Second half just about set to begin, and we got a tight game here.
He's out to the 30, and he's taken down at the 33.
This deficit can be easily overcome, sure. But they have to be thinking if they don't get something going on this series, the burden is going to be felt by their defense.
Oh, and he had some steam on that throw. Brought down at the 41-yard line.
Tackled back behind the line of scrimmage. They're about 4 yards away here on third down. And he tackles him hard at the 42. Bring him down around the 39-yard line.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. And here we go again. Here we go again.
Hey, look, Mike 15, guys. Mike 15.
lets it go.
Nice catch on that one.
Touchdown saving tackle, but it leaves him with a first and goal. Through a defender, and he's in. So the kicker will line up here and try to give his team a three-point lead with this extra point. He splits the uprights with the extra point. The kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. Lawrence fields at the goal line. And he's tackled at the 28-yard line. There's still plenty of time to keep running their offense as usual here. I don't think they need to feel any anxiety about trailing. He's to the 40. He gets out to about the 44-yard line. We've got a first and 10. Ball on the 44. Makes it to the 41. At the 30, the 10, and they finally knock him out at the 9. So first and goal after that huge run. Him down in the backfield.
The penetration by the defense was so good on that play that it didn't matter who the ball carrier was. Anyone would have been brought down for a loss.
Roger, Roger. 40's Mike, 40's Mike.
And he's tackled
around the 14-yard line.
Third and goal for the lead.
They get nice yardage on that run.
Nebraska is looking to tie things up. Kicks up, and it's good.
Even though they gave up a field goal here, that defense is feeling pretty good about themselves right now. It could have just as easily been a touchdown.
Cooper has the ball all teed up, and he's ready to kick this one off.
Taken at the 5. He's taken down at the 25.
Kirk, if this keeps going like it has been, we are going to have one exciting fourth quarter.
I just hope we continue to see this kind of execution. It's a lot of fun to be able to watch these offenses make plays, and it kind of has that feel. Whoever does have the ball last and a chance to make a play could win this game.
Well, the offense heading back out onto the field after that kick, hoping to turn this drive into another touchdown.
This offensive coordinator has got to be feeling so good about the execution that he's seeing from his quarterback and his wide receivers. Because, again, they put so much time into trying to put a plan together. And to be able to see that actually come into play makes you feel pretty good as a play caller.
Complete, brought down, nothing doing.
Check.
gives it off. He's pushed out of bounds at the 45-yard line. Fires it quickly. Tackle made around the 33-yard line. Quick strike to the receiver. The 26-yard line. It was the defensive lineman that got a hold of him there.
You're not going to break many tackles when this guy gets his hands on you.
Second down, and they've got 15 for the first down. Ball on the 26-yard line. Halfback's got it on the quick throw. He's taken down at the 10-yard line. He makes it out to maybe the 10-yard line.
Kill, kill, kill! 15,
36, 36!
Got it!
He brings it down! Touchdown! That was a well-drawn-up play for the wideout.
Yeah, they saw something upstairs. It led to a touchdown. You can thank the play calling there. Very impressive.
They got great concentration from everyone to connect on that flag pattern. And he adds the extra point. Oklahoma is ready to kick it away. Lawrence from the one, and he makes it out to about the 21-yard line. This deficit can be easily overcome, sure, but they have to be thinking if they don't get something going on this series, the burden is going to be felt by their defense. Nice gain as he works the right side. They're about 4 yards away here on second down. We'll head to the final quarter of play. Will the offensive fireworks continue? Oklahoma leads 31-24. Welcome back to the action here as we resume play here in quarter number four. And he's tackled after positive yardage. It's first and 10. Ball on the 34. And he's taken down at the 43-yard line. At the 40, to the 20, to the 10. He scores. What a play.
That was simply sensational running, and it shows you what kinds of major things can happen when you have a good ground game.
Here's the PAT to tie this thing up.
and he tacks on the extra point. And it looks like they're ready for the kickoff. Fielded at the four. He gets out to about the 28-yard line. This is when things get a little prickly. You need your playmakers to really come through here. Fires that quickly, incomplete.
I like the scheme the defensive coordinator came up with here. They were all over the place on that play and left the quarterback nowhere to throw it.
From their own 28-yard line, it's second down. And he's hit before he can go anywhere.
The defense was playing the run all the way. They got it right. Nice work.
Osborne back deep to return. They get this one off, and it's a beauty. He's out to the 30. He's tackled at the 35. And you know, it's basically like we're starting from zero here in a one-quarter game now. Every possession is vital. Quick throw. And he shoved out of bounds around the 45-yard line. It's second down, and they're about the length of the football from the first down marker. They nearly gave that ball away.
But luckily that guy was paying attention to what was going on and was able to recover the football.
He airs it out. Incomplete. And he misses his wide receiver there.
Yeah, you're right. This is an area that he's worked so hard to improve since day one. The accuracy of his throws. He's improved, but as you can see, he's upset here with himself.
Less than 3 minutes in the game. Sets up a screen. Tailback's got it. And they make the stop
around the 32-yard line.
From the 32-yard line, first down. Tries to buy some time. And down he goes at the 20. Makes it out to maybe the 19-yard line. We've got a second and nine here.
Ball on the 19-yard line.
Three down. 26, Mike.
Ready. Black 68. Black 68.
Makes it out to about the 10. And this play is number 8 on the drive. They push him out at the 1. Tied up here in the 4th. Now would be the time for a goal line stand. This defense not wanting to give an inch here. Touchdown, Cornhuskers. makes the PAT. Nebraska ready to kick this one off. He's to the 20. Tackle at the 27.
I love the competitive spirit that we're seeing out on this field today. It looks like one team has the upper hand, and then the other comes right back in to be able to regain the lead. It's going to be an exciting finish.
You know this is a real crucial time in the game. It could still go either way. Just over a minute left. Makes the grab and steps out right away. First down, 10 to go. Ball on their own 42. Catch there before he stepped out of bounds. First and 10. Ball on the 38-yard line. He's on the run. Tackle at the 36. He scrambled and picked up a couple of yards. Oklahoma's going to take their first time out of the half. He's hit and taken down.
I like the call here by the defense to bring the heat with the outside linebacker. It was just a better call by the offense, and that's why it's a first down.
Red two, green in.
He's going to try and scramble, and they got him.
Man, these guys can be aggressive. When you stand back there and take hits like that, you definitely are going to feel it the next day.
The spike will stop the clock. And this is the eighth play of the drive. Slings it left. Got a man. Watch out here. What a play. And that'll set up a first and goal. Pressure, and he's going to be sacked for a loss.
Hey, kill, kill, kill! Black five, black five!
Turn it up, turn it up. Three, nine, three, spikes nine. The ball. Here's the 11th play of the drive.
I'm here all day. 15's the mic. 15's the mic. I got 15.
Three, two, three, eight.
He's scrambling. The ball is loose. The offense scoops it. That tackle just sealed the deal.
Really great game to watch. Both teams should be proud of their efforts in this one. 38-31, Cornhuskers. As we wrap this game up, Kirk, what final thoughts do you want to share?
Nebraska came out here today and played with the heart and intensity that you love to see in a rivalry game. They should be very proud of their victory because wins don't come easy between these two teams.
That does it for this edition of NCAA Football 14. For Kirk Herbstreit, I'm Brad Nessler saying so long.